Good morning to everybody. I'm Stefano Masucco. I'm Rector Delegate for University Energy Efficiency, and I'm presenting the contribution University of Genoa Best Practices in Managing Energy and Climate Changes. My co-authors are warmly thanked, among them our Rector, Professor Federico Delfino, and our Pro-Rector for Sustainability, Professor Adriana Del. About the University of Genoa, it is one of the most ancient large European universities and one of the most renewed multidisciplinary public universities in Italy, with peaks of excellences in several scientific and technological domains. Some data about the University of Genoa: it was founded in 1481, it has 5 schools, 22 departments, some 32,000 students, and several international students. We have 4,300 researchers, including 1,200 tenured professors, and it has an annual income of about 28 million euros. The University of Genoa is spread into several campus, five of them. One is the main one is in Genoa, another very important one concerning sustainability is in Savona, and the other are Imperia, La Spezia, and Ventimiglia. The University of Genoa for Sustainability has the efforts have been very much in the last years. So since 2017, University of Genoa perform annual greenhouse gas inventory. In the period between 2021-2026, the University of Genoa strategic plan identifies sustainability as one of the 5 strategic development lines. The climate neutrality strategy between the years 2022-2030 has committed the University of Genoa towards climate neutrality within 2030. And the main targets are reduction in energy consumption and GHG emissions, while increasing the quality of life for university staff and students. The campus in Savona is specially focused on sustainability and smart city topics. Due to public financing called Energy 2020, the project, strongly wanted by our rector, Professor Delfino, allowed to install innovative energy experiment systems aimed at reducing pollutants emission and creating, at the same time, a comfortable working environment for campus users. The project has two main sub-projects: the Smart Polygeneration Microgrid, SPM, and the Smart Energy Building, SEB. Concerning the Smart Polygeneration Microgrid, the installation concerns natural gas turbines, power PV plants, photovoltaic plants, absorption chillers, electrical storage systems, electric vehicle charging station and grid control, an intelligent network feeding the electrical and thermal needs of the campus since 2014. The project is fully funded by the Ministry of University and Research and provided a significant CO2 reduction, cost reduction, as well as infrastructure recognized by the regional authority. Concerning the smart energy building, a zero emission building with high energy efficiency and accounting performance has been implemented. It has an energy prosumer able to produce energy by its own and, in case of need, to consume it from the smart polygeneration microgrid. The building management system allows to monitor and control the mechanical and electrical components of the building. Concerning the Genova campus, we have several settlements in the city, spread along the city, and we have also set up in the last, let's say, 10-12 years, a university energy saving working group, very active, which provide activities reducing energy management, energy efficiency at the Genova campus, and include the installation of an energy consumption real-time monitoring system, the implementation of a microgrid at the Department of Economics, the thermal energy accounts and other projects relating to energy efficiency and events to raise awareness of the energy issue. Concerning the energy monitoring system, it is provided by an ICT structure set up by a researcher at the university in cooperation with an ICT company, a local ICT company. We have 20 medium voltage substations monitored. The data are collected every 15 minutes and the system is available through a web service. We have a multi-vector energy consumption monitoring, a system performance indicators and benchmarking, and multi-building comparative analysis. The significant reduction in consumption is from 22 gigawatt-hours per year in 2018 to 18 gigawatt-hours per year in 2020, despite the use and increase in use of the electrical energy due to several installation and activities at the laboratories in the University of Genoa. The solution permits to correlate consumption and corresponding cost, to identify anomalies, waste and inefficiency, and to identify planned energy saving measurement to optimize also the offer on the energy market. An installation is also provided the Darsena microgrid, which means the Faculty of Economics, the School of Economics. It has a 20k kilowatt peak PV panels installed, two 10 kilowatts inverters, a meteo station, a 10 kilowatts, 12 kilowatt hours ion lithium storage system. The system has an advanced functionality that manages and controls a storage system coupled with renewable production. The control strategy is based on a mixed integer linear optimization algorithm. Other efficiency projects are concern load forecasting algorithm. The project is Predict, is a regional project based on our artificial neural network. Virtual power plant simulation, the Virtus project, which is a national funded research project, and other activities concerning energy efficiency investment and user awareness campaigns like an energy saving week, which involved the presence and the activities of all the students of the University of Genoa. What about University of Genoa greenhouse gas emission inventory? The activities started in 2013. The accounted office ground greenhouse emission permitted according to significant standards such as ISO 14064, three different scopes. The first scope includes direct CHG emission and direct emission energy emission, so that it was possible to attribute to the activity of University of Genoa the emission deriving from natural gas and diesel oil, leakage of refrigerant gases in the vehicle fleet. Scope 2 is directly related to the emission from electrical consumptions, and scope 3 includes other indirect emissions such as GHG emission related to water supply and consumption, waste treatment processes and emission generated by business trip and daily mobility of staff and students. The neutral strategies, University Climate, foreseen a 30% reduction in electricity, this is scope 2, and heat, scope 1, by 2024 with respect to data related to 2019. The table on the right of this slide gives an idea of the trends between 2019 to 2024. The main contributor to scope 3 and the overall GHG emission is represented by daily mobility. There is an important plan also in agreement with the municipality of Genova so that to incentivize public transport sharing, to have free discounted public transport travel cards for the students, mainly for the students at the beginning of their university career, the creation of university cycle paths, installation of bike racks. Green Deal mobility schemes provided for incentives of the mobility of Erasmus students and car sharing facilities. So this is the conclusion of my contribution, and I'm happy to participate to this international conference and hope that the cooperation between university and public administrations and research supporter will increase the attention to everybody to sustainability and green emissions. Thank you very much for the attention.